Hi everybody, good morning.
Good morning everyone. Hope you had a wonderful weekend. Happy to see some of you over on my YouTube channel, Classic Catholic. Glad to see some of you commenting on my videos. That was really nice to see you there. Hope you had a wonderful Sunday. I was happy to see so many people join me for the rosary on Sunday. During church, because yes, not only can you pray the rosary during Mass, but the way of praying the rosary and the prayer you're supposed to be doing at Mass are the same kind of prayer, so they are compatible and synonymous with each other. So there's a big misunderstanding in the church about how to pray the Mass. And you pray the Mass the way you pray the rosary. It's really, it's the same type of prayer, that meditative, heart-to-heart, sort of speaking to God, like, quietly in your heart. That's the kind of prayer that the Mass is supposed to be creating for you. So, that's why I go to the traditional Latin Mass, because that, the traditional Mass allows that, not just allows it, but supports that type of prayer, like the highest form of prayer. So, highly encourage all of you to check out your local traditional Latin Mass parish and give it a try. It took me a few years to finally understand it and love it. So, I encourage everyone to find one if you're looking for a more fulfilling and more adult sort of relationship. Okay, the volume's not very high. I apologize. I have a very quiet voice, and my baby's starting to fall asleep over here in her cradle. She was looking at me. Alright, so I'll try to speak up. But I'm glad to see everyone today. And we are doing, I believe today's Monday, we are doing Joyful Mysteries. So let's begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead, and he ascended into heaven. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. For an increase in faith, hope, and charity, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of thy mercy. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, we love you, save souls. Alright, I hear that the sound is weird, that something is buzzing. I have it plugged in to charge. Is it buzzing now? Because if I don't, my phone didn't charge last night, so if I don't have it charging, it will just die. And since it's plugged in to charge, I can't plug in a microphone. So I think this one will be a buzzing, quiet. So I apologize. I hope that doesn't get too distracting. So I hope that kind of cleared it up. I adjusted the cord as much as I could. Let me know. If it's just terrible, I'll unplug it, but her phone might die, so. Okay. So we're doing the joyful mysteries today, and we are, I would like to contemplate the mystery. Once again, we are doing this rosary from Michaelmas to Christmas, so join us every day. There's a group of us that have committed and promised to do our best to pray every single day at 9:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time here together to basically, we're really trying to comprehend the Father's will, like who this God the Father is as a person, and so that we can get to know Him better. And we get to know Him through the mysteries of the Rosary. So today, I just have this curiosity, this question about the Father's will that I want to contemplate during this Rosary. That's based on what we contemplated during the Sorrowful Mysteries last Friday. Because we basically came to the conclusion that the Sorrowful Mysteries are Him demonstrating how much He respects our free will. And His if He had free will, you know, if he had total control, as if He didn't give up some of His control to us, so if He was a tyrant, what would His tyranny be like? It would be a very lovely place, you know. People would all get along. It'd all be good because He only wills goodness. He does not will evil. He doesn't want evil, you know. If He had His way, we'd all be in heaven, but that's not how it works. You know, He wants us to earn it, sort of to have it for ourselves, because that's, you know, you can't have love if it's not free. So there's some sort of mystery there with it's better this way, you know, it's better this way somehow, to have the weeds mixed with the wheat, you know, the chaff, or how is that? How parable goes that some weed was scattered among the fields, and He said, just wait till the harvest to separate them, because we don't want to accidentally pull up some of the wheat when we pull the weeds. So that's kind of like our world that we live in today. We are mixed with evil and good, and within ourselves as well as just in the world. You know, you can't just say, I'm good, I'm all good, and they're all bad. It's like we have like a mixture, and it's at our death, or when God makes that judgment, when Christ comes as the just judge, that's when He separates the two out. But for now, it's better to keep it so that the good isn't lost. That's the logic there. So I want to contemplate here during the joyful mysteries, I want to contemplate this question of respecting our wills, respecting our free will. And so let's see if there's any answers in these joyful mysteries for us. So our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. I forgot to say, the first mystery, the first joyful mystery, is the incarnation of our Lord, the Annunciation, when He is incarnate in the womb. And this is the virtue that corresponds with this is humility. So, Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. So then how does my pride get in the way of God's will for me? If He wants only good things for me, and I'm obviously receiving good and bad, then that means the bad is coming from my own hand, from my own will, and other people around me, their own bad wills, too. It's not just on me. And even then, going back to generations and generations and generations, all of the bad will that's ever been put into the world by all of these people all the way back to our first parents. So we're talking about more than just you. You don't have total control over your existence. There is, there's a lot of evil out there that is against you that you have to fight against. It's bigger than just evil in you. Ave Maria Grazia Plena Dominus Tecum, Benedicta tu in Mulieribus, et Benedictus Fructus Ventris tui Jesus, Santa Maria Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. So for all of the evil, let's do some exorcisms here with these Hail Marys, and let's consciously will all of the evil in our family lives. So think of your whole family, have pulled them in your heart, and will that all the evil that's in them be removed and put on the cross with Christ. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. And let's focus on the good in them. Let's think about what's good in them. All the good that's in them. And offer it in thanksgiving to the Father. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for allowing me to exist. For bringing me into existence to my entire family, and for you to bless each one of them in the past. You can do that. You can bless them. And maybe it's your prayer of blessing on them that, God works outside of time, so who knows? Who knows what will happen when you pray for them? Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus. Et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. For the glorification of every single one of my ancestors, every single one of my grandmothers and grandfathers that came upon me. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus. Et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. That God may bless them spiritually and materially, that He may show them His generosity in all things. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. In thanksgiving for being adopted into the heart of Christ via my baptism, my confirmation, and via the sacrament of Holy Communion, for being included in this new lineage, this new family. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. And our final Hail Mary we will offer for better, for us to understand more fully how we can, how humility benefits us, so that we're not afraid of it. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Gloria Patri, et Filio, et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper. And in saecula saeculorum. Amen. And my Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are most need of thy mercy. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, we love you. Save souls. The second joyful mystery is the visitation of Our Lady to her cousin Elizabeth. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. So how does Our Lady's visitation reveal to us how God respects our free will? Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Now, I've heard it from a said, love and do as you wish. Love and do as you wish, and you can't go wrong. Because love is our, you know, willpower. So if we have love in our hearts, then that is what guides us to doing the right thing. So it seems like Our Lady, who is full of love, wished to go do something for her neighbor, and so did it. Like, anything that she would have done would have been good. This particular thing was good. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. And this decade is about perfect charity towards our neighbor. And, you know, when we have perfect charity towards our neighbor, then we have perfect love towards ourselves, because we love our neighbor as ourselves. And, anyway, you can't love your neighbor if you only love yourself. And if you only love yourself, you don't actually love yourself. You're just lying to yourself. You're just being yourself. So, that we may love our neighbors more perfectly. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. That we may love our family members with more patience and humility. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. That we may love God above all things. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. That we may love all things because we love God, for the love of God. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. That we may love our neighbor as if they are God himself. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Our final Ave, let's offer it for perfect charity in our hearts, that God will lead us to understand more fully what that even means, so that we can create it at will. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritus Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lord Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are most needed by mercy. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, we love you, save souls. The third mystery is the Nativity of our Lord. Our Lord's Nativity. And prayer, the virtue for this is love of the poor. So, how do we love the poor? I love this one, I think, the most, because I feel like it's the most misunderstood today. You know, we have all these politicians that are like, oh yeah, we're all about the poor. But how do you know, like, you can have good intentions, but do they actually produce good fruits? And that's really the question, because love, true love, must be willing the actual good of the other, not just the perceived good. You can't just, you know, it's like, okay, that's good that you think you're doing good for someone, but you need to do what actually gives them good things, like what is actually good for them. Hey, baby, are you playing or are you praying?
Yeah.
You're playing. Why don't you go play? How old are you?
Playing.
You're going to play?
Playing.
You're playing?
Playing.
Okay, well, let's see you're playing. No, that's not playing. That's playing.
Playing.
Here, I'm on my speed. Do you want to help me hold it? Right here, I think. heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Oh no, she can't hear either. Okay, no one can hear me, baby girl. Well, I feel like I'm gonna need to unplug it. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. No, I don't want you by the candle. It's very hot. If it spills wax on you, you could get burned. Nativity, love of the poor, Hail Mary, Ave. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieri, bus et benedict. Can you put that in the trash? Put that in the trash. Ave Maria, Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieri, bus et Madeline, you need to go in the other room. Go. No, go play with JoJo. Go play. You gotta be quiet. Ave Maria, grazia plena. Dominus tecum, benedicta tu. Let me know if you can hear me better too, you guys. I unplugged it. But if it's no different, I'll plug it back in because I need to keep my phone charged. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieri, bus et benedictus fructus. Alright, guys, you woke up the baby.
No, not okay. You woke up the baby.
I'm gonna wake you up. Come here. Benedicta tu in mulieri, bus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Excuse me. Okay, so we're contemplating love of the poor and God respecting our free will. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieri, bus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei. Girls? No. Well, then close the door. I'm going to play in here. Okay? Close the door. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieri, bus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei. Ora pro nobis peccatoribus. Nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. You can't play on my lap. You can play in here. You can play in here, just not on my lap. Okay. Nope, not on my lap. Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieri, bus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus, Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Excuse me.
I know.
Okay. our free will because he wants us to love the poor, but to do so freely. There's no law forcing us to do it. We do it without obligation. Right? Otherwise, that feels weird. No one likes it when someone just does good things for them because they have to, and they don't really care. That's kind of horrible. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostra. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostra. Amen. But I was just thinking about certain orders of religious who serve the poor in different ways, but they take a vow to do it. And that's kind of interesting, because that relates to your will, your free will. You choose, just like with marriage, you freely choose to bind yourself to follow this law. That's fascinating, isn't it? Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. So if you have a vow to love the poor, like Mother Teresa's sisters, that means you have now put on yourself a law to love them. So does that defeat the point? Isn't love supposed to just be free all the time? Like, I thought we're not supposed to have the law forcing us to do it. Interesting. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis. Ooh, no. Pick them up. Pick them back up and put them in the bag. Pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. So somehow, once you become an adult, you realize that the inspiration to just feel like loving people and doing the right thing requires assistance from others to keep you honest. Ave Maria, gratia plena, with yourself, because it's honestly what you want to do, but because we're weak, we stray and we fail. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. I apologize if this affects the sound quality, but I need to put my phone in. So Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus. So it's as if the law we put ourselves under helps us remember later on down the road what our promises were and what we actually want, what our true will wants, when our weak will, our fallen will, starts to stray. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Girls, you need to quiet down. They were being a little too loud. Okay, Jacob? Thank you. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritus Sancto. Superaret in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. My Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are most in need of thy mercy. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, we love you. Save souls. The fourth joyful mystery is the presentation of our Lord in the temple. The purification. The circumcision. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. So here we have four, and we give the first Ave and poetry. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis. Peccatory loose, and then put an arm more to his nostril. And then we'll pick those up. Shh. Shh. Don't pick up what you just threw. Don't pick it up. Okay, so here we have that perfect example. And it didn't even occur to me. Here we have Christ demonstrating how to submit to the law. He didn't have to be circumcised. They didn't have to present him at the temple. Like, he's already fulfilled the law. But they did it anyway. Not just to show us that we should follow the law, but because he knows the value in the law, that it keeps us honest with ourselves. It's a good thing. The law is, he's showing us the law is a good thing. We see it as a bad thing, that, but that's because it's our weak will that sees the law as a bad thing. It's our strong will, our true will, that recognizes the good in it. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus. A benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus, Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. It's almost like we have two sides of our will. We have a little more flexible side, we have a stricter side. And it's like we need that help from each other to keep us honest. Even here, praying the rosary every day, by putting our names on a list, by talking to each other and encouraging each other. We're helping us keep our promise. That's an act of the will, to make a promise. It's not like a vow or an oath, like, you know, it's like weddings or religious life, but it's similar. It's like, I promise to try my best, to, you know, make my will as strong as possible. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. So I want to do a little exorcism here on our weak will, that we can exercise that weakness from us that makes us lose sight of our goals. You know, let's exercise that with this Father. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis. Hey, girls. That's mean she's playing with that. You're playing with blocks. She can play with that. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Oh, did you not put power over my room? I'm so sorry.
Sorry.
Can you fix it again? You're good at making towers. Make it with a running block or two half. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Okay, so submitting ourselves to the law willfully. So this is the thing, isn't it? This is the thing. Choosing freely to be submissive to the law. That's goes back to the humility part. You know, to have humility to submit. Because the devil, he does not submit to the Lord. He has to, but he doesn't do it willingly. He doesn't. He said, "I will not serve." That's what our bad voice inside of us, or our bad will, tells us, you know, that we should, that serving and putting ourselves under other people will just curse us. It'll just ruin our life. We can't trust them, we can't trust anyone, we have our good in mind. We definitely can't trust God. It's that voice. So let's exercise that evil voice from our heads. We will never listen to that voice again. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus,
A benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Our final Ave. Let's pray for a blessing. A blessing on us and our whole families, that we may all become servants of God's holy will. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Gloria Patri et Filio, et Spiritui Sancto, sic erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are most needed. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, remember you, save your souls. The fifth joyful mystery is the finding of Jesus in the temple, teaching the elders. Oh, we pray for wisdom. And also with this prayer, I'll be offering up your prayers aloud. So make sure you put your comments below, and I will attach them to our offering. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. To find all lost and return loved ones to the Holy Mother Church. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Scroll up for some more. Take care of Felix at home, and a permanent job for Joanna. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
No, babe. And how did you get that? No. You can stay in here. Close the door. Stay in here in this room. Getting on top of the refrigerator. I don't even know.
No, just being right. I know what you're doing. You come in here right now. Get in here. No.
No. Well, you lost your opportunity because you didn't want to come to know people.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, bene. Oh wait, I missed a couple, sorry.
I think I saw for Madison and Julian and Ian and Duncan. It's Carolyn's breath. And
to help Jake.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. For MGA's prayer, too long, so I'm just going to say that. Gilberta to be healed from a cold and inflammation virus, whatever she has. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. For healing from illnesses and miscarriage and infant loss. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. For good health and protection for all. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus,
A benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus, Sancta Maria Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae, amen. For peace in Anika's family, for peace in all families throughout the world. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae, amen. For Tina's medications, so that she may feel well, Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae, amen. For Micheline, and for anyone else dealing with autoimmune and skin conditions, Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Ave Maria, Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae, amen. Careful. Our final Ave, so I just want to pray for healing and all graces and blessings on everyone and their families who are praying live with us right now. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae, amen. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, and in saecula saeculorum. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, excuse me, pay attention, and no, don't stand right here. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are most need of thy mercy. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, we love you, save souls. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve, Ante Clamamus, Exodus Fili Heve, Ante Suspiramus, Gementes et Plentes, In hoc lacrimarum vale. Advocata nostra, illustris misericordes oculos, manos converte. And Son, by whose life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal salvation. Grant, we beseech thee, that while meditating upon these mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary and the Blessed Virgin Mary, that we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise, through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. We are protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast from the well of Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. And Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. Immaculate Heart of Jesus, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Okay. We are all done today. I think that went faster than normal. I think go faster, yep. We're almost, I've got to say goodbye to everybody. And then we can, goodbye, everyone. We've got to go do ballet. We're doing ballet. Yeah, we're doing ballet today. One of these days, but...
And there's Samuel.
I did promise Josephine to do ballet right away. And we went over so long last time, was it Thursday, Saturday, that I feel like we should do this today. Oh, but it's good to see everybody. I'm glad to join that you're joining us. Join me every day, 9:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, if you're new watching
and
this
there's
right now.
Eleanor.
There's a big group of us that are encouraging each other
and
to keep our promises to pray every single day until Christmas so that we come to have a better understanding of God the Father. And what he's doing. Can we not do this right now? Later. So we're praying to better understand the holy will of our Heavenly Father, because His will is only good. And so we're contemplating how that is possible, and that's what we're doing with each mystery. Okay? So please join us, and thank you everyone who joined. I was happy to see so many familiar faces.
Now he's going to do a ballet instead of me.
Yes, I'm going to go do ballet. Okay, so thank you. Can you guys say bye?
Bye.
Bye. You may bye.
Bye.
I can't see you there, but yeah. Oh, there you are. Bye. See you next time. See you tomorrow.
Maddie did.
Yeah, it's Maddie. Is it?
Maddie did.
Yeah. All right. Bye. Thank you, everyone. God bless. Have a wonderful day.